were last night. Taking an 8-hour break to help get up to see the roads up. I've been hammered down every time I woke up. We make a good time now. We're about an hour or so from Walcott. So over there, we're gonna stop it. The boss man might stop there, he just left Du Bois. So, say he might stop. Does when I have breakfast. I buy him breakfast this time. If he lets me. Half the time he won't let me. But, yeah, we'll have breakfast with the boss and then we'll probably have a shower and a shave and might get a haircut while I'm there. Hair out of my ears, it's driving me crazy. But it's nice, it's raining, but it's nice. 35 degrees, I like it. So I'll probably go ahead and do a full break there. Walk on, leave us tonight. By the time we get there, we'll be a hair over 1,500 miles from Boise. So I only need to do 500 miles a day to get there. Saturday night, Sunday night, Monday night. Easy cheesy. What I like about this run is I have plenty of time getting back. I ain't got to hurry. I ain't worried about weather. If it delays me, no big deal. Be able to make it all the way to Brooklyn, but it took y'all around so y'all can see. There you go. What I got going on this morning. I don't mind the rain. Or you might snow as long as it don't ice up on me. Well, Wilma this morning was got trucking along here. I noticed my damn engine pan kept kicking on. Engine tip was running up around 210. She cooled off when her fan came on, but it just warmed right back up. I stopped to make sure she had fluid, cooling. I walked around in front of the truck, and the whole front of the truck was just covered in about a quarter inch of ice. Well, she was getting hot, she couldn't get no air. The whole grill was just solid ice. I had to go out there and hammer it all off, break it up, knock it off. And she's been running fine ever since. Now it warmed up, so it just came down. Woo! Crank it up! Sometime today, must be nice going across Iowa and Nebraska. So that's good news. A radar, a side radar over there is having fits. Keep beeping at me. Back around. There you go. Can you see me now? Belinda, you gonna ask for, my first time I heard Stevie Ray Vaughan. I guess I was about, I don't know, 11 or 12, first time I heard him. We hung out with, when I was a kid, we hung out with a bunch of bikers down here in Texas. And they had a little band. And the bass player, Ryan, he always, about every weekend to a party at his house. He lived down in South Austin. And, hell, I mean, there'd be probably 30 or 40 bikers show up. Damn thing about beeping. Anyway, they play music and big old party. Me and my two sisters I grew up with, we'd hang out in the backyard with this St. Bernard, playing around out there, just listening to music. We'd fetch beers for people for tips. We'd make quite a bit of money on it. Somebody played some Stevie Ray Vaughan, you know, album or tape back then, but I thought I loved it. First time I heard it, fell in love with it. So I got my first album is Texas Blood album, and I wore that thing out. My favorite song back then was Pride and Joy. Then I heard his first time I heard his live, heard a live recording of it. It blew me away, man. He was so good on guitar. Just blows my mind. It's funny now, there's a YouTube channel that I watch, James Mason. He has a reaction channel. And pretty small YouTube channel. And he acts in different music and trailers and all kinds of stuff. And I suggest that he listen to Stevie Ray Vaughan's Ain't Gonna Give Up on Love. He had never heard of Stevie Ray Vaughan. The only blues that he had ever heard was B.B. King. And it blew him away, man. He was like, wow. He's done a couple other Stevie Ray Vaughan reactions, man. Blows his mind every time. You go watch him. They're pretty good reactions. James Mason. Pretty good. I love watching people's reactions that I've never heard of before. Even people who don't like blues or don't know anything about blues, they listen to that and they're like, wow. You know? My toe. My second toe on my right foot. I'm stomping off the snow on my on the step out here. I actually kicked the side of it. Man, it still hurts like hell. And every time I try to bend it, man, it hurts. There ain't shit you can do about a broke toe. Man, it hurts.
Gave up and got back in the right lane.
there and he wasn't going to pass for it. I'm going to have to pass him, Werner, and Walmart. It'll take me all day, too. It's the deal when I'm just doing it back there and ran into a tree. I'll get off here. Take my messages. See what he wants. I'll talk to you folks later. Have a good day.